Right, so if you want, a detailed step-by-step, process of how to install the Greenworks foam cannon, the tool daily foam cannon, how to change the orifice, and the five no quick connect nozzle tips, click on the link in the description. So here I'm just going to skim through changing the orifices, from the tool daily, and subsequently in the video I'll show you how to wash your car with quality detergent or foam, and also how the different five nozzle tips perform, when rinsing your car or taking out gunk, skunk or grime. So I've got two orifices in my hand. One is 1.1 millimeter, the other is 1.25 millimeter. I'll be fitting or swapping, the 1.25 mil for the 1.1 millimeter, okay? The 1.25 millimeter came with the tool daily. I want to use a smaller size orifice for more power and more pressure. Okay, so this is the quarter inch quick connect. I've installed that directly into the spray gun. I review this extensively. If you want, check the links in the description. You should find it there. On how to choose the right adapter, which is a nil fisk for your spray gun. Don't use the Bosch, like I said. So I've just installed the black nozzle, and I'll be installing subsequent nozzles, the red, the yellow, the white, the green, in the same fashion, and testing out, how they perform, while spraying. So basically that's just the process, yeah? And again, check the link in the description if you want an extensive review of how these nozzle tips perform. The spray angles or spray area, okay? And the electric pressure washer in question is Greenworks. The yellow nozzle is a 15 degree medium stripping tip, great for removing dirt and mud. So it's pretty much got a 15 degree spray area of spray angle. The 40 degree white nozzle tip is for minimum spraying. It is low pressure and it's great for fragile surfaces like windows and blinds. And you can clearly see it's 40 degrees and it's low pressure, okay? It's not like the yellow nozzle. The 25 degree green nozzle tip is great for lifting and cleaning. Probably the most common nozzle tip for use around the home is great for your boat, your car, your patio, your furniture, and driveways, okay? Cold water machines use a downstream injector for applying soap. The black tip nozzle is often referred to as a soap nozzle. It has a larger orifice and the widest degree angle at 65 degrees. This low pressure nozzle allows the downstream injector to draw the soap. So pretty much the downstream works at low pressure, to draw the soap. Whilst the red nozzle tip provides a maximum blast, it's got a 0 degree angle, which makes it unsafe to use on many surfaces. It could prove useful in removing tough caked on mud from construction equipment, or rust. Just pretty much hold it at the right distance to remove top stains from high strength concrete. That's about it really. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Catch up later, bye. So here I'll be pretty much testing the G30 Greenworks pressure washer with the Greenworks foam cannon, the aftermarket tool daily foam cannon. I'll be changing the orifices from 1.25 to 1.1. So first, I'll be testing out the Honeydew Snow Foam Auto Wash by Chemical Guys to see how effective the Honeydew Snow Foam is, in terms of how much lather or foam, I can get out of the snow foam. Alongside the original foam cannon that comes from Greenworks, the default foam cannons that was supplied by Greenworks. So, the blast from the orifice to see, the power and, how foamy the snow foam comes out from the cannon or detergent tank. And as you can see, it's drippy foamy. It's not really that thick, it's quite runny. And you just about have, enough detergent, to cover the car. And, I would ascribe a lot of the lather, to the Honeydew foam wash, as opposed to your conventional car wax wash that wouldn't give you a lot of lather, So it just about does the job. But the thick foam is not at the level that I want it to be. So I've pretty much done two runs and it's still drippy and runny. So I would, you know, swap the Greenworks foam cannon with the Tool Daily foam cannon with the original Orifice. And you know, for the foam cannon detergent mixture, just mix anywhere between 1 to 3 ounces or 30 to 90 millimeter of the chemical guys and foam wash, you know, with warm water, because it helps aerate, you know, the mixture a lot better. You know, just pretty much fill the mixture in the detergent tank and, you know, couple it together, you know, onto the Tool Daily foam cannon, and we're going to test it with its original orifice. I notice here that the black knob is a variable nozzle adjuster, so you can adjust, you know, the angle, the spray angle, and you know how the foam latches onto the car. So pretty much testing out the 1.25 millimeter orifice, then subsequently testing out the 1.1 millimeter. So let's give it a shot and see how it sprays onto the car. So as an example, I'll show you why it's important to vary the nozzle. So I'm not going to variate the nozzle in this instance. I'm just going to, you know, restrict, you know, the spray angle. But, you know, just basically test out the 1.25 millimeter orifice. And you can pretty much see that, you know, it's quite runny. So not varying or adjusting, you know, the knob to increase the spray angle of the nozzle just pretty much means that, you know, the detergent in your foam cannon lasts a lot longer, but you may not have, you know, the foamy effect or the lathery effect as soon as, you know, the detergent impacts on the car. So subsequently, I will be changing the orifice to the 1.1 millimeter. And, you know, adjusting the spray angle, and let's see how that impacts on the car. Because pretty much at this stage, you know, the foam mixture is still quite runny. It's not thick. So here I'll be swapping the 1.25 millimeter default orifice with the 1.1 millimeter orifice. And if you want to see, you know, how to set up your Greenworks machine to get in the adapter for the Greenworks, and you know, how to, you know, select your 5 nozzle tips, you know, as well as how to connect your garden hose to your kitchen tap or your bathroom tap, as well as how to connect, you know, the adapter, your kitchen adapter, for your faucet aerator, just click on the links in the description, and you know, you'd find useful tips there. So I'm pretty much, you know, swapping the orifice. So I'm installing the 1.1 millimeter orifice, and you know, subsequently I'd be mixing up the detergent, and you know, would be spraying the car. So here I'd be installing the 1/4 inch quick connect with my adjustable spanner, and you know, then subsequently installing that, you know, onto the 1/4 inch spray gun adapter, which is what we have here. So I'll be putting that, sticking that into the 1/4 inch, you know, adapter. You know, I've already got that fitted, you know, onto my spray gun. But like I said, you know, if you want a detailed step-to-step guide or tutorial, click on one of the links in the description and it should take you to the relevant video. And so the next step would be to test out the 1.1 millimeter orifice. But this time around, I will be varying the nozzle of the foam cannon. And as you can see, it's quite foamy, and this is what I want. So once the lather of foam settles, I'll proceed to rinsing. So I've been pretty much adjusting the nozzle. So now I'll probably do about 2 runs, you know, on the car, and let the foam lather seep and seat on the car for some time. So I'll be pretty much rinsing the car without any nozzle attached to the spray wand. And so here I'd be installing the turbo nozzle, and if you want more details, just click on the link in the description for more tips. And so let's test the turbo nozzle. Lovely weather, isn't it? You know, just make sure you're not washing your car in direct sunlight, and make sure that when you're, you know, spraying your car, you are at a considerable distance, as you do not want the impact of the pressure washer to start, you know, yanking off paint from your car. So just be reasonable about the distance that you're keeping from your vehicle, okay? Or read your manufacturer's instruction. And so now back to rinsing the car, let's test out the variable nozzle. And let's pretty much install the variable nozzle for Greenworks. And don't mind my dirty hands, you know, it comes with cleaning. When you're cleaning stuff or doing plumbing work, you know, your hands are expected to be dirty. So the turbo and the variable have got pretty much the same spray outburst, but it's just that, you know, the advantage that the variable has is that you can adjust, you know, the spray angle, and you know, the car is looking sparkly, bright and clean. So the next stage would be to install the 5 nozzles and see how they spray, you know, with regards to rinsing your car. Again, if you want details, just click on the link in the description. It should take you to the relevant video. So I'd be installing the 5 nozzle tips, you know, to the quick connect of the adapter that goes into the spray gun. So the black soap nozzle sprays at a 65 degree angle. And so the green nozzle sprays at a 25 degree angle. It's the most common nozzle and is great for your car, your boat, your patio, your furniture and your driveways. Whilst your yellow nozzle tip sprays at a 15 degree angle. It's great for medium stripping and is used for preparing surfaces for painting. The white nozzle tip sprays at a 40 degree spray angle. It's used for minimum spraying and it's low pressure and it's great for fragile surfaces like your windows and blinds. Your red nozzle tip, you know, provides maximum blast and it's got a spray angle of 0 degrees, so do not use this nozzle on surfed surfaces, okay? And that's about it really. Don't forget to subscribe and share, helps the channel grow, and hopefully catch up with you soon. See you, bye!